I am here to give you advice on A-levels. So during A-levels, I would make notes every week based on what was taught in each subject. This meant that I wouldn't waste precious time on making material near actual exams. I made notes because it helped me consolidate the information, but you could make flashcards. Just with flashcards, I'd recommend going through them every day or every couple of days. This means you can build on knowledge more easily during A-levels. Whenever you make your resources, make sure you have the specification up with it, because this means that you cover everything that you can expect on the exams. And during lessons, if you don't understand something, always ask your teacher to explain. Understanding something just means that it's easier to memorize. And if you're in year 12, it's likely that the stuff that you learn right now will be built upon in year 13. So understanding the basics are beneficial, if not crucial. So don't just pass it off as a yeah, whatever. When it came to revising for any topic tests, I would have more time to just go through questions instead of wasting more time making resources. And whenever I learned something new from the questions, I would then add that to my notes. And when we got the test back, I would make a separate set of notes. On this page of notes, I would sort of write down the mistakes I made and any sort of knowledge gaps that I had. I could look at this extra set of notes before actual exams, so that way I don't make the same mistakes when it actually matters. I would revise in a similar way for mocks, but I would also make a revision timetable. This helped me visualize how much time I actually had before a mock. But I would use past papers as the main source of revision. And again, I would look through the mistakes and I would learn from it and add it to my notes. Here, it is important to look at the mock scheme, because you should learn what they're looking for. For example, if a question is about a practical, you should learn what they've put as an ideal answer. Learning from mock schemes is the most important thing I want you to take away from this video. And when I did the papers, I would do it question by question. So I'd do a question and then I'd review it and then move on to the next question. Unless you want to practice your timing, then do the full paper and then review it. And for year 13 mocks, I would go through the flashcards on physics and maths tutor. These flashcards provide a fresh test of your knowledge, especially if you've never looked at them, like me. And remember that extra page of notes that I made from past exams? I would use those going into the mocks and into those actual exams. And for those actual exams, I would make another timetable. On here, I have put in the flashcards from physics and maths tutor that I would cover. And I would also make a separate piece of notes for any knowledge gaps that I found I had in these flashcards. It may seem a bit empty, but during A-levels, I've always been building up my knowledge. And that meant I don't need to spend as much time revising for the actual exams. And plus, we did a lot of question packs during the actual lessons. And again, I would learn from my mistakes. And I also planned when I would do past papers and then learn from the mistakes that I made in those past papers. And again, look at the mark schemes, because it just makes it easier for the examiner to give you the marks if you know what they're looking for. And when I've been writing down my mistakes, writing down model answers, that just puts it into my short-term memory. You know, in the exam, if I see that similar question again, I know exactly what I'm writing down. And when I'm going through these past papers, like actually going through the answers, I would have a past paper walkthrough alongside it. Because for some papers, the explanation or the mark scheme isn't quite clear. So when it didn't make sense, I would go through the video and hopefully actually understand how the answer makes sense. And if you want to know how to get an A star in any of these four subjects, then the link to the playlist is here.